Hi everyone. You are on the Software Developer blog channel. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and also like this video. I think everyone once dreamed, or at least thought about, how to make their own game. Maybe someone had a cool idea, and someone just wanted to delve into the process itself and see how games are made. In this video, I will tell you how cross-platform games are created in JavaScript today. We will review the existing JavaScript engines, consider the basic principles of these engines and the logic behind building game architecture. In fact, games today can be written in almost any programming language. Another question is what platform this game will be for and how highly loaded the project will be. JavaScript has already proven its ability to develop high-quality games, and as you might expect from a language that has a large number of frameworks and libraries. There are many variants of game engines that make it possible to create games using the same programming language, JavaScript. There are Unity, Unreal Engine, CryEngine, Rage, and other cool solutions for creating games. They have more functionality to create really cool games. GTA 5, Fortnite is proof of this. Why do we need game engines at all? This is the main core, the basic software on which all other components are built. This is a program code that can be used to create different variations of the game. It is responsible for game logic, object physics, object interaction rules, and gameplay in general. Let's start with Phaser.js. It is one of the most popular JavaScript engines that can be used very quickly even by novice developers. Phaser allows you to create HTML5 games for PC and mobile devices. Some of its features include proper display and images, various control systems, and it has robust physics engines. The framework uses both canvas rendering and WebGL, and can automatically switch between them based on browser support. One of the advantages of using this particular framework is the opportunity to join a large community of developers. You can get support and help on forums, conferences, and social networking groups. This is great support for people taking their first steps in game dev and need guidance. Apart from JavaScript, this tool also supports TypeScript. One of the most popular 3D libraries is 3.js. It offers a set of functions for performing common operations that need to take place in a 3D scene. With it, you can work at a higher level than with raw WebGL, and you do not need to bother with the low-level details of their work. On the 3D scene of any game, even the simplest, there are standard components, such as surfaces located in a coordinate system, a camera for viewing the scene, lights and materials for better visual perception, as well as animations to bring the scene to life and more. 3.js, like any other library, provides out-of-the-box functions to help you implement 3D. 3.js is very easy to use and has a low barrier to entry, so once you start learning it, you'll quickly get the hang of it and be able to use it to its full potential. Babylon.js is considered a complete JavaScript framework for creating 3D games. It is a good choice for 3D and also VR. Using WebGL for graphics, the feature set for Babylon.js is quite extensive. It covers everything you would expect from a JavaScript game engine and also adds additional features not often found in freely available systems, such as mesh processing. Let's take a look at the functionality of Babylon.js for a bit. Using its features is enough to write an entire game on your own. Here are some of the most significant. Support and export tools for Unity, Blender, Maya, and 3ds Max. Core game engine components such as scene control, collision handling, and scene graphics. Particle and animation system, performance optimization, shader systems, rendering, and textures. How to get started with Babylon.js? If you want to quickly create a game, you can take a look at the source code and documentation for Babylon.js on their official website. Do something very simple by example. They offer a range of tutorials and examples to help you get started quickly, even if you're new to game engines. In general, game development is a complex and lengthy process. If your goal is not to create clones of games like Snake, Tetris, or others, then it will take a lot of time and effort. Too many people, trying to immediately create a game on a large scale, like Minecraft, run into difficulties and give up their idea. Try to start by creating a simple two-color linear platform game that takes a couple of minutes to complete. It will already be a big success. Game development is interesting and exciting. Games are, first of all, creativity. That's all for me. Thank you all for watching. See you soon.